Dana White's Contender Series Season 6 Week 8 is here, and I'm going to be breaking down every fight on this card and predicting how I believe it will go down. This card seems really competitive. Yeah, it should be fun to break down. There's some good prospects on this card also. So yeah, let's get directly into it. We have Brandon Lewis versus Daniel Marcos. For Lewis, he is 6-1. His last fight was a win over an 11-6 opponent. Fought in the 2021 Contender Series season and lost. In that matchup for the Contender Series, he got out grappled for most of the fight. Does have some solid takedown defense, decent jiu-jitsu, but he was looking for subs in his guard in that Contender Series matchup. His stand-up is good, just tends to not set up his opponents with strikes, and ends up just hitting their guard. Doesn't really set guys up. He kind of just throws things out there. Isn't too technical in that aspect. Marcos, he's 12-0. Last fight was 3 years ago. Isn't the best in the grappling department. Can get taken down, but has decent grappling himself. He likes to be in the stand-up as well. This is a mess of a fight, mostly due to the fact that Marcos is such a big question mark in this matchup because he hasn't fought in 3 years. I'm going to go with Lewis in this matchup, mostly because of the 3-year layoff for the other guy, and I feel a lot more comfortable choosing him. And yeah, just the activity is beneficial for this decision, but it could easily swing the other way. I'm probably not going to bet on this fight anyways, but yeah, I'm going with Lewis for a decision. Up the card, we have Bruna Brazil versus Marnik Mann. Brazil 7-2, good stand-up, keeps the fights at a distance and with her hands down. Likes to work the whole body, takes a couple minutes to assert herself into the matchup, and has alright takedown defense. Mann, 5-0, solid grappling, isn't very technical on the feet, but often looks to counterpunch. I'm going to go with Brazil here due to her... Let me move the check mark over. I'm going to go Brazil here due to her good stand-up and her being able to defend the takedowns. I think she'll be able to use her size to stop the takedowns and use her range to avoid situations that will get her down. Use her range, inflict damage that way, and win by a decision. Nothing crazy there. Just another lower-level women's MMA fight. Could go the other way, though. That's how these kind of fights go, especially with the Contender Series and women's MMA multiplied by each other. Wonderful. But in all honesty, Brazil, she's actually very technical. I just wish she had a higher output, in all honesty. But yeah, she's actually solidly technical. I think I'm scrolling through the whole thing. But yeah. Up the card, we have Malik Willis versus Trevor Peak. Lewis is 5-0, has some good power in his hands, has some good combos on the feet, good jiu-jitsu. A bigger, more powerful fighter could probably take him down, but the power would be very necessary to do so. The way he gets taken down is basically picked up and slammed down on the ground. He is very good at defending the takedown in general. For Peak, he's 6-0, has some good hands but not comparable in KO power, likes to work the whole body, has some good combos, but I'm going to give this fight to Lewis. Let's move this over. I'm going to give this to Lewis just because of his power alone. There isn't too much Trevor can do to defend those big shots. I think they're both kind of evenly technical, if not Trevor is more technical in this fight, but I just think the power shots from Lewis might give him some issues here. I can see Lewis KOing him or maybe getting a decision if Trevor survives for that long. Up the card, we have Ikram Aliskarov versus Mario Souza. Aliskarov is 12-1, had the single best performance against Hamzat not named Gilbert Burns. Also beat Dennis Tuiluilin, who just beat Jamie Pickett this past weekend on 279. Does have a great sambo wrestling background and jiu-jitsu. He did some solid work against Hamzat wrestling wise until he did get KO'd, which is absolutely brutal. Sosa, 14-2, was on the Contender Series before, has good stand-up. Sorry. Aliskarov in this matchup will take him down to the ground and absolutely destroy him. He'll either sub him or ground and pound him, and that's how he'll get the win. Nothing crazy there, but in all honesty, that's just how dominant of a fighter he is. And that's how good Hamzat is also. Up the card, we have Alan Bogoso versus Farid Bashirat. Bogoso is 7-1. Great power in his hands, good variety in his striking. For Bastrat, he's 8-0, good on the feet, good on the ground, and has some good finishing ability. I can see this ending in a decision win for Bastrat. He can take guys down and do well on the feet. So I think that what he will do here is that for basically a 30-27 decision. He'll just mix in the takedowns with the striking. He's very technical on the feet, has some obviously some good grappling, and I just think he's going to mix it in for him, and that'll be a little too much for his opponent. Bagasso, I believe is how you say it. Yeah, should be a good card. I'm excited to see Bastrat and Aliskarov, especially Aliskarov, very talented fighter. Only losses to Hamzat, and he was relatively competitive there in the grappling. But yes, should be a very entertaining group of fights for this card. But I hope you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys next time for... I don't even know what my next videos are going to be for the week. But yeah, I'll see you guys next time.